do. Hi. All right. Let's play some more Judgment. Huh? Our boy Yagami, not doing so well, huh? Very heavy blood loss. We're inside the bottom of the ADDC with Sugira, and we're fucking trying to get Kuroiwa.
Kuroiwa!
What the fuck? Oh shit! Shit's like a fucking ghost lorry. What the fuck? Oh, this is Okubo seeing the... finding the body, right? It's just Yagami. I thought the scream was Sugira behind me, but it was the scream of Okubo. It's just like hallucinating on the blood loss, really. He's just fucking in. Man's very, yeah, very lightheaded, and he's just like picturing Okubo finding the body. The fucking zombie, the Pokemon zombies. There actually is a Yakuza non-canon, obviously, zombie spin-off. It's the first Yakuza game I ever saw, because it was Ray playing it one day. It looks so fucking weird. There's Shintani.
ゲージ弁が本当信念とか正義かそういうのが試されるんだ。あんな金にもなんねえのによ。いいからほどほどにしとけって。経験豊富な先輩のありがたい横言葉だぜ。
We have zombie shit in this too, don't we? In Judgment or just in the series? In the house that burned down?
This floor was the one. You can go to the development center.
That was just in a flashback. We never actually get to play that. A hotel. Oh, the fucking the guy in the gimp suit. There's Emmy. Yeah. Emmy and Yagami when he was younger. This is after Waki's body has been found and Okubo has been convicted.
So
that'll be the case that Yagami wins. Emmy.
Okubo-kun, onegaishimasune, Yagami-san. Ato. よかったら弟のことも涼しいですけど。ヤガミさん。あ、その姉貴の声がしたんだよ。あ、いや、空耳にしては生々しくて。なんか聞こえた。ああ、後でゆっくり話してやるよ。今はやることがある。
And I think we're in a position to fight Kuroiwa again.
Scoshi Kaoiro Yokunata.
Okay, I can save. I'm feeling better, probably, not the term I would use. Yeah, I really can't. Just double checking. Okay, no saves before we go into this.
Card key. Gold no yasu ne.
Beep. Beep away in. On we go. Windows all fucked, probably from the explosion of the bridge being blown out.
Shono wa kono furoa ni
hinan shite nakereba na.
If Shono turns out to be like really good at fighting, that'd be really, really funny. Because he's just like a little dweeby kind of scientist. Kuroi was the problem. Oh shit.
Yagami-san.
Shono?
Shono?
There's Kuroiwa.
Kuroiwa.
Tokoton jamashite kureru na. Yagami.
Yamero! Imasara fukushu shite nan ni naru? Shono o koroshite mo omae wa
fukushu? Dare ga sonna koto o?
こいつには生きていてもらう。オッケー。何?銃を捨てろ。クライス。 You're like Mr. X from Resident Evil 2, huh? Big coat and everything, huh? No, ah, fuck's sake.
Sugiura.
が来られるようにする。ああ。矢神さんは黒岩とすぐに決着をつけてくる。ならいいよ。そんな慌てなくて。僕の分までやっつけてきて。分かった。俺たちはあんたを助けに来た。本意じゃねえけどな。
こいつを見ててやってくれ。わかりました。
Chucking chemicals at him.
諦めろ。
全て終わりだ。うるせえ。まだ終わりじゃねえ。どういう意味だ。アドデックナインだよ。あの存在がある限り俺は終わらねえ。あんたさっきショウノには生きていてもらうって言ってたな。ああ、あいつと俺とでアドデックナインを完成させる。
奴だってそれを望むはずだ。俺らが助かるにはもうそれしかねえ。そんなことができると思うのか。ああ、できるね。やってみせる。I was gonna fucking jack himself with Resident Evil style, huh? 完成するまで。I thought he had like a vial of it or something. 実験台を調達してやるよ。Oh god.
薬さえ完成させれば。 捕まるどころか、世界中に感謝される。
正気じゃねえ。
じゃあまず。
Here we go。
お前を久しぶりの実験台にしてやる。死んじまったら、その時はお前も目えぐってもらえ。
My health. Doom. Mitsuru Kuroiwa, took you PD organized crime division. Boys, my fucking health. Help. Fucking pack at sushi and those fucking bantus on there. It's like. Blah, 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 blah.Bang. Oh. I'm looking the wrong way. Why am I keep looking the wrong way? Why does he keep... I keep blocking and he keeps turning his fucking back to him? Yeah, can we go on to that, please, huh?The fucking block's no good if it blocks some boy like a fucking ghost. I'll get a fresh health bar now, at least it's good. Shono and Sugira on the left there. Sorry lads, we're just intruding on your face a wee bit here. Oh, this guard break is so good. Ooh, get up. Fuck me, yeah. Wham! Can you fire the bantus on this? Alright, one last sushi set, some more. Oof. Boom. Shit. Oh, God. Oof. I love the hand-to-hand stuff like in the cutscenes. Kiryu doesn't do too much of it because he's kind of bigger, whereas like Yagami's very like he's like leaner, yeah. He's more flexible in the way he fights. Oh, fucking battered our knee down. Oh shit. Oh. Slide on the glass. Ow. Okay, we have game logic how we don't shred ourselves in the glass. What's he got though? He's gonna pick up fucking shards of glass or something though. This is a fucking great setting for a final fight though. We've now entered the. The Hunter DBZ portion of the fight. Oh. You need the force? Oh, fuck. Oh. Oh my god! Fucking ragdolling her. Ah. starting up again. Fucking hell, him. Oh, I can't get up. I'm just using all my healing items, so. I mean, when else am I gonna use them really, right? This is the fucking, presumably, one of the last fights. Fuck me, huh? I know what I need. I need my the extract that lets me break the thunder strike. Lets me break through guards. Time to fucking pile on the healing items again. Fuck you. Bang! Fuck off. That's a great fucking the roundhouse. Get him. I mean, he's definitely hanging on the edge, right? Yep. Why won't you just die? Was I right? He can inject himself! If he fucking hulks out like a Resident Evil character. Oh, fucking hell, he's got a full health bar again. Shit! He's doing it again! Oh boys, I'm fucked. Ah. Oh shit. I went fucking ham on my healing items, I thought that'd be it. I do have more of the extract at least, so. I didn't grow a giant fucking arm or like eyes in his stomach or anything like that, so. It's not that extreme. And heal up again. Do you not think the way he holds his hand out looks like he's trying to use it like that, kinda? Is that what he does? Like the tiger palm, right? I guess what that's called. When you like curl your. Unless I'm misremembering the way he holds his hand. Alright, let's break his guard again. I'm gonna take more of the Thunderstrike extract. Oh shit. Fuck! Ah, oh, bastard. I tried to press my bloody start button, but he got me. Okay, we're round two at least. Yeah. Oh, like that? Yeah, kind of, yeah. Doing force squish. My favorite move, eh? Yeah, no, I can see it. Uh-oh. Take our extract. Fuck your guard. Boom. Boom. Kick him again. Holy fuck. That gave me a bit of a wound there, boys. I wonder if you can do that again or. Fuck me, man, it's so strong. I need these are my last healing items. These 10 bento lunch sets and then one more healing kit. Fuck, I'm getting I am getting the shit kicked out of me, hey? Fucking hell. If he catches me with a single attack, my fucking health is gone. Because you can't buy the healing drinks in this one, like you can in the main series, you're reliant on just food.
Boom.
Six bento sets left. His fucking kicks are so strong. I'm trying to lock on to him, but punching the wrong fucking way. This is our last assault. Take our extract so we can break his guard. Boom. Right. If there's another fight now, we can just die and have a fresh health. Fuck me, he's so strong. Oh, what a great setting, huh? Oof. He's just tanking it, though. Must be just a... like adrenaline he's injecting himself with. There's the boys. Isn't that the cops he beat up?
You.
さっきやっと誤解が解けてよ。一旦俺らのことは後回しにしてくれるってよ。後で弁護頼むぞ。
They're gonna start shooting them. It's gonna be like Agent Smith from Matrix, like fucking dodging them all, hey? Shono? Uh-oh.
Shono?
Ah! Jesus. Shouldn't move out of the way, you fucking idiot. Oh. Oh, Jesus. Here's our dosage.
それは?
No, a lot of them. I think most of them die at the end. Nishiki blows up at the end of Yakuza 1. Or you mean like this, like kind of gunned down? Nishiki blows up. Ryuji in 2 also dies, but I don't remember how. Mine jumps off a building. Yeah, I'm trying to remember. I'm trying to go back to them.
That's
Getting the proof.
So yatte nan nin koroshite kita.
On Shono, confess.
Demo, okage de nanbyaku man, nanzen man no hito ga sukuwareru n desu.
Dakara tsumi mo nai onna no ko made koroshita. Han? Nando mo karada o sashite hi made tsuketa. Sono tsumi o kiserareta Okubo-kun wa ima mo shikei shu de iru n da.
Boku datte koroshitakute koroshita n janai.
All on video. Kiro flipped when he realized there was a new one inside.
つまりアドデックナインは失敗です。しかし彼は誰にもそれを言えずにいた。すでに何人も死なせて、その全てが無意味だったと言い出せなかった。
あなたがその話を聞いたのはいつですか。つい先日ですよ。それを聞いて私はこの法廷で証言することにしたんです。世界を救うためには仕方なかった。違うだろ。お前がエミちゃんを殺したのは
自分の保身のためだよ。世界を救うのが目的なら、アドデックナインの研究は他の誰かに引き継ぐことだ。僕が研究してきた薬だ。僕でなきゃ完成させられなかった。じゃあ今証明してみせますよ。僕の考えた薬が正しいこと、僕のやったことが正しかったってことをね。You're gonna use it on himself? Yeah.
おい。僕の母は認知症になった祖父母を長いこと介護してた。それを最後まで看取った後、気が抜けたように倒れて死んだ。僕だってアルツハイマーに大事な家族を奪われた一人なんだ。
でも、これでもう同じ悲劇は二度と起こらない。この薬の開発を手掛けたのも It won't kill him if it's successful. That was the problem. It was killing its test subjects. What? Or at least that's what he hoped to prove, in a way. He'd be proven that's not fatal anymore. Did fucking... Could Roy do something about it, or did he... Does it just not work? He's hanging on out of spite.
Oh god.
Yeah. Forgot about the pigmentation. That's why they would stab all the eyes out so you couldn't tell. Forgot about that part.
So natteva mou tasukaranai. Aoku naru no wa Adodeck 9 ni yurai suru dokuso ga tamaru tame da to Shouno-kun wa itte mashita. Sore wa magire mo nai jintai jikken no bussho to natte shimau. Dakara
Kamuro-chou de mitsukaru shitai kara wa. Eyes were removed, so you couldn't tell. It's the first time we've ever seen it. Kind of scary. Didn't work. Hope that the end was free. Yoko. 10 days later, Tokyo Detention Center. Free the mans. He's cut his hair.
ありがとうございました。
I'm just gonna apologize to him. I brought Sugira.
Oh.
<clears throat>
一緒にいてくれればいいのに。じゃあな。ガッディメイドアズウェル。ありがとうね。ヤガミさん。Very sweet.
ショーンのと黒岩は死亡。一ノ瀬や森田検事生は逮捕か。矢上探偵事務所のおかげですね。でも、これから大変なことになります。厚労省は大揺れでしょうし、創薬センターも。多分。やっぱり、will it get closed down after all this? 結局、梶平の狙い通りになっちゃったりして。
納得いきません。いや、そっちはそっちで風見大臣との癒着が追及されるみたいだ。警察が動き出しているんだとよ。天網恢恢、ソにして漏らさずだ。こっそり悪いことはできないってことですね。おお、よく知ってるな。じゃあこれ知ってるか。はい。うちの事務所は社内恋愛禁止だ。
仕事に身が入んなくなるんでな。いやー、そうだったんですか。そこは引いちゃダメでしょ。まあ年寄りの忠告ってのはいつも無視されるもんだ。若い頃は俺らも忠告なんて聞かなかったか。なあ。
There's two surrogate dads. I'm glad Genda lived at least. Matsugane dying is pretty shit. At Starbucks?
まあ、俺は別に構わねえよ。お前が弁護士に戻っても。今ちょうど依頼もねえし。 俺は他で職探してくっからよ。何言ってんだよ。俺はここを閉める気ないって。せっかくまっとうな世界に戻れんのにか。こんなろくでもねえ街で探偵続けるなんて、どう考えてもアホだろ。言ってくれるね。カイトさんの言う通りじゃない。今の矢上くんなら弁護の依頼で引く手あまたなの。The case of...
A long time. 神様の
おぼしめし？
それだ。
よしてくれよ。
え？
俺は弁護士を辞めて探偵になった。でも探偵という選択をしたから大久保君の冤罪を証明できた。
それはまあそうかもね。
皮肉なもんだよ。弁護士やってて真実をつかめずに逃げ出してたってのに、弁護士を辞めたことで真実にたどり着くことができたんだから。どんな選択にどんな未来があるかなんてわからない。それこそ神のみぞ知るだろ。だからどんな選択をしたところで大事なのはその後さ。絶対に諦めないことが一番大事なんだ。
まあね。
でもさ。
ん？でも？
法廷で久しぶりにスーツ着たけど、俺いまいちじゃなかった。スーツ着るって選択だけはやっぱ絶対なしかな。その点、探偵はスーツ着る必要ないし。
Only leather jackets.
あのね。
And jeans.
はい、矢上探偵事務所。え？猫が逃げて帰ってこないって、うちはペットショップじゃねえんだから。
いいね、面白そうじゃん。猫の名前と特徴は？
ちょっと矢上くん。
チャコ、5歳のメス。じゃあ写真送っといてください。よっしゃ、じゃあドンキでまた旅でも買ってくっか。
カイトさん、久しぶりの依頼だ。絶対物にしようぜ。
Very funny. Imagine the end of Ghostbusters when they do this big case and then all the fucking requests are coming in. Oh, Matt played the English voice of Kuroiwa. That'd be fun to hear. I don't care at all for the Yakuza dubs, but to see a Matt's name there as Kuroiwa, like, interesting. Crispin Freeman was Kaito.
Yagami!
Fucking Winton. Steve Bloom was Higashi. Yeah. Robbie was Kengo. Kengo's a pretty small role. Kiki Silverstein. Who was Fan V? I didn't catch who they were playing by. Or who they were playing. I don't recognize the actress's name that much. We'll do our overall thoughts after the credits as well. Needless to say, very positive, obviously. Oh, it's definitely okay. Got a song on there. Special appearances? The MCU? What? Okay? I don't think it's that, but it's funny seeing it there. And big ups to the stunt coordinator, because a lot of the hand-to-hand fighting this was really good. Like in the pre-battle cutscenes and stuff, like the mid-battle stuff. A lot of the hand-to-hand, like, the blocking and stuff was great. Really, really good. Like, Kiryu has much more of, like, a brawler kind of fighting style to him. Whereas Yagami's a lot more, like, flips and using all aspects of his body. He's probably closest to Akiyama. Although Akiyama really just uses his legs like Sanji from One Piece. Cut. Short little hour stream to finish off. Very nice one. What are they doing? Are they trying to get the cat? is that the cat they were looking for? That's probably the one from the call. This has definitely left me in a spot where I'm really looking forward to Lost Judgment, the sequel. But again, I'm just being patient. Happy to see Black Spire. We'll be on for Living Force. Yeah, we're a couple of chapters into Queen's Peril at the moment, only like chapter 4 or something, so. But we'll get to Living Force when it's done. No, oh, you can repeat the office. Knowing that Living Force probably not okay for Blind Wave. There's less of a rush, so. Cut! I put a message into my team's chat with Blind Wave today about, like, the number of books we have left, the number of books I'm, like, vetting that Noodle and I still have to read to see if they're okay, and, like, my, upcoming batches of comics and how many books they unlock. Oh, this is the opening music. I listened to this on YouTube quite a bit. I'm sorry. Yeah, if you could do all of it, I'd appreciate it. I can. Like, my guess, based on that tweet that talks about how the it references the High Republic. I assume that's really just, like, the fact that the outposts are a thing. Do we phase 3 spoiler? I don't think so. My guess is really just that it'll be, like, stuff about the outposts. But, you never know. Yeah, I don't think we're getting anything more than that. Thank you. Complete all of the main story. Yeah, I think our post-grad scene was a little non-serious one of just them finding the cat. Which I'm okay with. And that's it for Judgment Time. This was excellent. Really good. I think this is, in terms of, like, number of streams and also, like, length overall, I think this is the longest Yakuza game so far, and I think that actually tracks if you look on like how long the beat not is the longest so far. The next one, Yakuza Like a Dragon, 18% people did it. Let me see. I mean, it's a long game, like, so yeah, there you go. Oh, it's a platinum, sorry, not the platinum. There you go. You're gonna hear my voice. All my trophies record. Whenever I get a trophy, it records the audio from my mic. I enabled that. So I'm gonna see if you can. There's some funny ones. Yeah, like 18% or something like that, was it? 17.3% of players, yeah. So yeah, 18% basically. The next game, which is Yakuza Like a Dragon, which is the Ichiban game, is like even longer than this again. Big. It's a big game. No, I had a very good time with this. Like, it's very interesting they have this one, and then so they have Yakuza 6, The Song of Life, which it is a really good, like, bookend point for the kind of Kiryu Haruka story, right? It ends with I say a good point. It ends with Haruka and Haruto, like, I don't remember the end of Yakuza 6. I cried. It's when, like, the ending is like Kiryu has, like, I think Kiryu fakes his death, and then it like you see the orphanage in Okinawa, and Haruka, because he wants them to be safe, right? He wants his Kiryu a fucking tea, you know, making this decision for them, and it's like Haruka and whatever Haruto's dad's name is, Yuta or something like him, whatever his name is, and Kiryu, like, comes to the orphanage, and, like, he watches over the wall, like, just to see them with the baby, and then, like, I think Haruka thinks she sees him, but he turns to walk away just as Haruto starts walking for the first time, and it, like, every time Haruto takes a step, it cuts to Kiryu walking, and it's, like, pairs there walking together. Ah, end was so good. So that's where we've left the Kiryu story. And then we have this, which is, like, a whole new... granted, this is, like, technically a side spin-off series, the Judgment games. And then the next one, with Ichiban is the next main game, but it is the same in effect. Like, we have Judgment now. We have our new main character of Yagami. We have our new supporting cast. I don't know how many of them come back in Lost Judgment. I assume Kaito does. I think Kaito has his own DLC in Lost Judgment. Like, the Kaito Files or something like that was really fun. But, like, Kaito, we've got, like, Mafu, Sugiura, Higashi. We've got this whole new cast of characters. The Law Agenda, Hoshino, Saori. We have this whole new kind of cast. And then the next game, we're going to do it all again. And we're going to meet Ichiban. I don't know anything about him except that everyone loves him. And we're going to meet that whole cast of characters. And then after that, it's Lost Judgment, which is the... Yagami 2, basically, the Yagami sequel, which I've heard is excellent. This is also fantastic. We'll talk about, I know I'm kind of talking around this, but I'll talk about Judgment specifically. So then we have Lost Judgment, which is the Yagami sequel. After that, we have, Yakuza Like a Dragon and Lost Judgment is kind of the turning point where the Western name of the franchise has now also become Like a Dragon. It's no longer Yakuza. So after Lost Judgment, we have Like a Dragon Gaiden, the man who erased his name, which is the kind of Kiryu smaller bridge game between Yakuza Like a Dragon and Like a Dragon Infinite Wealth. I don't know really anything about the story of Like a Dragon Gaiden. It's Kiryu after Yakuza 6. He's like a secret agent or something like that. I just know that people cry at the ending again. I'm not prepared. And then we've got Like a Dragon Infinite Wealth, which is the Kiryu and Ichiban game that came out earlier this year. So we've still got a few to go, and they're big as well, like, so it'll be a while. We'll not be caught up. Personally, my big hope for the Yakuza series, or the Like a Dragon, whatever you want to call it, my big hope, I think the series is quite... I don't like talking negatively about the series, I really love it. I would really love the series to get better with its female characters. Like, I would love... and not in the sense that I think they're bad. I just don't think they're important enough. Like, the female characters always usually... Like, Matthew's fun. Saori in this was a lot of fun. But, like, specifically, I think to Yakuza 2, when we had, like, the Yakuza Hunter, the cop lady, who was the sister of Ryuji, the main villain. Yeah, she kind of became a love interest for Kiryu, which you can argue, yes, is a problem in itself, that she had to be that. But I thought she was fantastic in Yakuza 2, and then she gets kind of, like, written out of the story really quickly at the beginning of Yakuza 3, which is really sad. Like, at the start of Yakuza 3, she and Kiryu kind of part ways, and you never see her again. She hasn't been in the story since. My big hope would be, like, I really want another, because I think the universe is great. Like, it's relatively grounded. It's like I said, Cobra Kai, it's, like, grounded, but with, like, anime influences and stuff. So there's only so much you can really do. But this worked fantastic as this, like, detective spinoff. I would love another spinoff and have a female main character. That's what I'd really like. Or we could do one in the main series, sure. But I think we're still kind of in the weeds with the Ichiban Kiryu stuff. But in the meantime, I would love another spinoff with a female protagonist. That's my main hope. Anyway, Judgment. Really, really good. I really liked... right from the start, the kind of the detective nature of the story being separated from playing a Yakuza protagonist really clicked with me. Although there's Yakuza elements, like with Kaito being from the Tojo, and we had a lot of Tojo influence with the Matsugane family, Higashi, one of the other main kind of antagonists who was part of the Matsugane as well, Hamura. You know, so there's a lot of Yakuza elements, which is fine. You're in Kamurocho, that the fucking Tojo is there, and any other fucking families and groups here or there at that one time. But the story really clicked with me. I found at certain points near the start, towards the middle, when they started introducing the ADDC and the Ministry of Health element, I started to find the story a little bit difficult to follow. Because the story initially is about, like, the killings of the Kyore clan, and then there's the mole. So initially, it's just like, oh, there's a serial killer hunting Yakuza. And that was relatively easy to follow. And then they started introducing the ADDC and the Ministry of Health and 89 and stuff like that. I'm like, right. I didn't really know where it was going. I found it kind of difficult to follow. But I trusted the writing, because I trust they wouldn't bring in this massive plot element if it didn't have anything to do with anything. So I was like, right, I'm going to see where it goes. And then they start threading the two stories together, and you're like, oh, this is like a giant conspiracy that meshes these two storylines. And from that point on, once it started, like, it becoming clear that they were very intertwined, I was like, oh, okay, I see what we're doing here. And yeah, I had a great time. Like, I really like Yagami as a main character. I love Kaito as, like, the sidekick character, really. Which we sometimes have with Kiryu. Like, in Yakuza 3, we had Rikia. And in Yakuza 6, we had the boys, right? The group of guys. Including Haruka's what becomes her baby's father, like that group. Like, there was the arsehole guy and his boys, and then you, like, you humble them, and then they're your friends, right? Like in Dragon Ball Z. So it does it sometimes, but here we had like Kaito was with us for a lot, and then we got Sugiura at one point, and basically Sugiura was there the whole game as well, and Higashi kind of came in and out as well, and then we had like the Genda office. We'd always touch base with those characters and stuff as well. So the characters were a lot of fun. The fighting, the look of the game, fucking fantastic. It just looks so good. Like, I love the actual cutscenes. Once they jumped onto this engine specifically, which would have been like Yakuza 0, both Kiwami games. So technically I would have had this at the very start, then not had it for a while, and then had it back. So because I started with Kiwami and Kiwami 2, which both had it. Then 3, 4, 5, I didn't have it, because they were like, maybe 5 did. 3 and 4 definitely didn't. And then it kind of came back with maybe around 0, 6 and all, and ever since then, they just look fucking incredible. Like, the cutscenes are so good. I love the way the characters look. It's similar when I talked about in Cyberpunk. I love just watching the characters, watching the models of the characters talk. It's the same with these games. I love how the characters look. I love how they move, how they animate, how they talk. I think it's It's a weird thing to touch on, but I just find it fascinating, so I had a really good time. But overall, really, really liked the game. This was the first of the games so far that I've actually told myself to slow down and just enjoy. Anytime a side thing pops up, just do it. Because usually I would do maybe one or two, and then just I would be so into the story, I would avoid them. But I purposely told myself here, stop doing that. Slow down. And like, anytime you see a side thing, just do it. And I did anything. We did all the side cases that I saw anyway. And we had a blast with them. Like sometimes I would be like, I really want to continue with the main story, but I'll go to this. And it was always funny. Like the boy fucking losing his toupee, or I'm with the fortune teller lady, the guy dressed up as the vampire that you had to help get away from his fans and stuff like that. Like it's very into the nature and the blood of the games. Didn't need the same stuff five times. Sure, there were some of them kind of were like a storyline, right? But I didn't mind them because I found they're either fun or like I enjoyed the story really. But yes, I had a very good time with this. I'm really looking forward to coming back for Lost Judgment. But next time is, for the series anyway, is Like a Dragon, or Yakuza Like a Dragon, the Ichiban game, which I'm very excited about. But that's not for a while, because this means now, whenever this slot comes up on Saturday of next week, so less than a week from now, we're going to be starting Control. And we're going to be going from Control into Alan Wake 2, and then into Yakuza Like a Dragon. That's the current plan anyway, unless something else pops up. But that's our current plan. And we're going to finish Pokemon on Thursday? We're going to finish Pokemon on Thursday. And then we'll start the Outlast Trials as a proper slot on the Friday. So, very exciting. Huh? So, thanks for watching Judgment. Ton of fun. Really, really liked it. Yeah, so next stream will be not tomorrow, because it's Monday. I'm at my board game club. Tuesday with Final Fantasy. So, thanks for watching. Random little hour on Sunday so we can finish Judgment. But yeah, enjoy your evening. I'll see you on Tuesday. Bye-bye.